Hello everybody, this is Sandeep Jagani, your operations and quality management friend. Today we are going to discuss what is Six Sigma in statistical terms. So let us start by defining what is Six Sigma. According to American Society for Quality, Six Sigma is a method that provides organizations tools to improve the capability of their business processes. These tools are commonly referred as DMAIC. D stands for define, M stands for measure, A stands for analyze, I stands for improve, and C stands for control. The Certified Six Sigma Green Belt Handbook, second edition, written by Munro, Ramu, and Srimayak, refers Six Sigma as the general concept of continual improvement. There is a statistical reason or logic behind why this continual improvement methodology is called Six Sigma. As you know, in statistics, Sigma is the standard deviation, which is the measure of variation. So plus or minus Six Sigma inspired the Six Sigma terminology. The goal here is to produce no more than 3.4 defects per 1 million opportunities. In this video, we will try to understand how do we come up with this number 3.4 defects per 1 million opportunities. Let us understand this using an example on the next slide. Let us assume a hypothetical process that produces certain kind of product with the dimension of 5 plus or minus 0.012 inches. That means the lower specification limit is 4.988 and the upper specification limit is 5.012. Always the specification limits are given by the customers to the manufacturer. Let us also assume that the data collected from a shift indicates the mean of mu equals 5, exactly 5 inches, and the standard deviation sigma equal to 0.004. Let us try to understand this concept using a number line. Suppose in this number line, the mean of 5 inches is somewhere at the middle, which is the target of the manufacturing process. The lower specification limit as specified by the customer is 4.988, which is on the left-hand side of this manufacturing process. Anything produced of lesser length than 4.988 inches are termed as defective units. On the right hand side of this process, we'll have the upper specification limit of 5.012. Anything or any rod produced longer than 5.012 inches is termed as a defective unit. And all the products produced within the specification limits are good products. We know that the standard deviation of the process is 0.004 inches. Therefore, now we can draw a normal distribution curve that this process would follow with a mean of 5.00 inches and the standard deviation of 0.004 inches. We can calculate the proportion of manufactured units which are of length below 4.988 or above 5.012 inches. The area under the curve, the shaded region as you see on the slide, can be calculated using the Excel formula norm.dist. And in this case, the proportion of the units which are below the lower specification limits are 0.00132. Similarly, we can calculate the proportion of defective units on the right-hand side tail of this normal distribution curve. This time we use the formula 1 minus norm.dist to calculate the proportion of the defective units which are beyond 5.012 inches, and the proportion is identical to the proportion that we found on the left hand side of this normal distribution curve. This is because the process currently is centered. That means the center of the process is exactly 5.000 inches. This is a rare scenario because we are only allowing common causes of variations. So what is common cause of variation? Consider if there was no variation and we were aiming to produce the products of 5.000 inches. So the every unit produced using this manufacturing process would be exactly 5.000 inches. But if there are common causes of variation, we have a standard deviation for that, which in this case is 0.004, and we get a normal distribution curve. The other type of variation is a special cause variation. We call this special cause variation because the causes responsible for the variation are special, which are assignable. We can assign those variations to certain activity, certain person, or an equipment which is bad or misfunctional in the process. So if we correct that activity or we train that employee, or we correct that equipment that is bad, we can correct the special cause of variation. Therefore, now we can conclude that the common causes of variation are something out of our control and something we have to live with, while the special causes of variation are correctable causes of variations. The current figure that you see on your screen represent only the common causes of variations which cannot be correctable. And therefore, we have a normal distribution curve. And here we are assuming that there is no special cause of variation. Therefore, our process is always centered with the mean of 5.000. Further, the total defectives can be given by the sum of the proportion of defectives in these two tails, and that is 0.27%. We can say that the proportion of good products produced will be 99.73%, and for every 1 million products produced, we will have 270 defective units. Remember, this is the ideal case where we are not allowing any special causes of variations. However, in practice, there will be certain kind of special causes which will shift our mean from exactly being 5.000 to plus or minus few units. There is a general agreement on somewhat arbitrary rule that assume a plus or minus 0.5 standard deviation shift of the mean. Let us represent that logic on the number line. Now we are going to allow the mean to shift plus or minus 1.5 standard deviation on the either side of the current mean. Therefore, the tolerance for the shift of the mean is plus or minus 1.5 standard deviations on each side. Let us consider the extreme cases where the normal distribution curve or the process is shifted to a mean of plus 1.5 standard deviation. Therefore, we will have more number of defective units on the right-hand tail, while we will have almost none on the left-hand side tail. If the process mean is shifted towards the minus 1.5 standard deviation extreme, then we will have the defective units only on the right-hand side tails, and there will be no defective unit on the left-hand side tail because we have the left-hand side tail is within the specification limits. We can also calculate the proportion of defective units, which is the area under the curve below 4.988. We can use the Excel formula to calculate the area of the shaded region using the norm.dist function. The proportion of defective on the left-hand side of the normal distribution curve tail is 6.68%, and there is no defective units on the right-hand side tail because this right-hand side tail is within the specification limits. Had the process mean shifted to plus 1.5 standard deviation, the right-hand side tail will be outside the upper specification limit, and the area under the curve would be also 6.68%. So there can be only one side which can be outside the specification limit, and the defective units will be 6.68%, which means the proportion of good units will be 93.32%. Therefore, we can say that for every 1 million products produced, we will have 66,807 defective units. For this particular process, the tolerance limits are located plus or minus 3 standard deviations apart. Therefore, we can call this process as 3 sigma process. Next, let us assume that we have established some degree of control on the common causes of variation. So we can reduce the standard deviation a little bit. Let us assume that our new standard deviation is 0.003 inches, and therefore our new normal distribution curve will look like something like this. We will still give this process some room of variation for the special causes, and let's say that our mean is allowed to still shift from minus 1.5 standard deviation to plus 1.5 standard deviation. Again, we are going to consider the extreme case of the mean shifted to minus 1.5 standard deviations. The area under the shaded region, or the proportion of defective, can be calculated using Excel, and this time the proportion of defective is 0.62% only. Therefore, the proportion of good products is 99.37%. For every 1 million products produced, now we will have 6,210 defective units. Also note that our new standard deviation is 0.003 inches. That means our specification limits on either side are plus or minus 4 sigma or 4 standard deviation. That makes this process as a 4 sigma process. Next, let us assume that our standard deviation can further be reduced to 0.002. So our new normal distribution curve would look like this, which is a little bit more steeper. If we still allow the mean to shift between minus 1.5 standard deviation to plus 1.5 deviations, we can see that a tiny proportion of the curve will still come outside the specification limits. We can calculate that proportion that is outside the specification limit for one of the extreme cases. For these extreme cases, when the left hand tail is outside the lower specification limit and the right hand side tail is still within the specification limit, so the proportion of defectives on the left hand side tail will be 0.0034% of the total products produced. Therefore, we are able to produce 99.997% of good products. In other words, for every 1 million products produced, we are going to only manufacture 3.4 defective units. Please note that for now, the standard deviation is 0.002, which makes our specification limits plus or minus 6 standard deviations apart. Therefore, we call this process as a Six Sigma process. We can summarize our results in this table. Statistically speaking, a Six Sigma process will have no more than 3.4 defects per 1 million opportunities. In case of any questions or concerns, please do not hesitate to contact me on the information displayed on the screen. You can also write a comment on the comment section below the video. Thank you.